Glory to God. Yes, yes, yes.
Anybody hear me?
Yes.
Bless
the Lord.
Wow.
Bless the Lord.
Jesus,
hallelujah.
Jesus, Jesus. We thank you, Brother Elder. Amen. Of course. Brother Richmond said that he's a retired soldier. Now he's a soldier for the Lord.
Amen.
I've never been a retired soldier. I've been in the Army. I found out that when you're on the battlefield for the Lord, sometimes you get wounded, sometimes you get hurt. I got my made up mind that I'm going to please my commander chief. CEO of my life. And his name is Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I got a made up mind no matter where I'm at. I done made my mind I'm going to serve him.
Yeah,
I'm going to serve him till I die.
Right,
yeah, I didn't say preach. I said serve him till I die. Jesus said I didn't come to be served, but he came to serve.
Yes.
I got in the service here this morning. We're all God's servants.
Yes, yes, yes.
But nevertheless, we want to first and foremost give all the honor.
Yes, yes.
Glory.
Yes.
Praises.
Mm-hmm.
To my God, to our God.
Yes.
The creator of this great universe.
Yes.
To my Lord and Savior, Jesus, which is called the Christ.
Yes, yes, yes.
He's my Redeemer.
Yes.
He's my Savior.
Yes.
To my precious Comforter, the Holy Ghost. One left the poor pit, but to the message of the gospel. We thank you, Elder Starr, for your presiding this morning.
Bless
you. Minister Adams, for intercessory prayer to our deacons. And I want to thank also the chairman of the Pastoral Search Committee, Sister Janice Robinson, and her staff for allowing me, welcoming back the second time to stand as a candidate as a pastor of this next church. I'm truly humbled and honored by that. To our deacons, if I haven't stated them, to our mothers, and to all of you in their respective places. I'm so glad to see your smiling faces this morning. I thank God for the Bonds family being back. Reached out to them yesterday and look at God. All of you, what we do. But nevertheless, I'm not going to carry your patience too long. If you had your swords, could you please stand with me and go up in two places this morning? Put a pen right there. We'll start right in Acts. What's one verse? The fourth chapter. Fourth chapter. Book of Acts.
Mm-hmm.
If you can stand and you're able to stand, you're standing for God's word.
Amen.
It's God's word. Acts chapter 4, verse 12. And the word of God reads this way. Neither is there salvation in any other, for there's none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. Can you hold this, just put it over there, we're going to flip over to the book of Philippians. Chapter 2. And I'm not going to have to do a lot of reading, but I just want to focus on some verses I'll probably cover in my message. Amen? Start with the chapter 2 of the book of Philippians, or Epistle of Philippians, whatever you want to call it. Starting with the 5th verse, chapter 2. Paul penned these words to us and to the Philippians. Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made himself of no reputation, and took upon the form of a servant, and was made in the likeness of men, and being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Wherefore, God has highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name.
Yes.
That at the name of Jesus, because I say every knee should bow of things in heaven.
In earth,
and the things on earth.
And
verse 11, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of the Father. Let us pray. Lord, we come this morning just as humble but as boldly as possible. We come thanking you, O God, for everything that you've done in this place thus far. From the Sunday school up to this appointed time. And now, O God, I need you to make preaching and teaching easier, O God. Use me, O God, as an instrument of holy use. None of me, but all of you, O God. From too high, bring me down. From too low, bring me up. Put me where I need to be, O God. The word declares your word won't go forth and come back forth. But now I ask you to touch your precious people in a special way. And maybe they've already received something up to this point. But Lord, let them be encouraged in this word today. If they already got it all figured out, let them, if they need this place to serve, that they may tell somebody about this man called Jesus. Well, have your way, let your will be done. And somebody, Father God, has not given their life to you. That they might come running to the altar. They might cry in their seat, asking the question, what must I do to be saved? Have your way, let your will be done. And we'll forever give your name the glory and all the honor. Because it all belongs to you. In Jesus' name, we do pray. Amen. This morning, I want to lift a message entitled, There is Something About Their Name. There's something about their name. And I want to tag this morning. You will call it. Church, extra, extra. Read all about it. Church, we are living in the last evil days. The Bible is clear about this in 2 Timothy chapter 3. But note this. In the last days, perilous or dangerous or wicked time will come. For men will be lovers of themselves, lovers of money, boastful, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unfaithful, unholy, unloving, unforgiving, slanderers, without self-control, brutal, despisers of good, traitors, headstrong, haughty, lovers of pleasures, rather than lovers of God. They'll have a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof. Right. Yes. Paul put it this way, from such, turn away. Check this. They're always learning, but they're never coming to the knowledge of truth.
Right. Jesus.
Paul picked these up in Ephesians 5 and 16. He said, declare, redeem the time of the days, because the days are evil. Jesus declared this in Matthew 16 and 14. A wicked and adulterous generation seeketh after a sign, and there will be no sign given except the sign of the prophet Jonah. But I want to stay there this morning. I want to hasten along. I come to preach this morning. There's something about that name. Well, my brothers and sisters, Webster and Oxford Dictionary defines the word name as a word or set of words by which a person, an animal, place, or thing is known or addressed or referred to. Church, if you don't hear anything else this morning, we can't come together with one thing this morning. One thing that we can agree on this. Every last one of someone. Can I get a witness?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Come on. Yes, sir.
There's something about a name.
Yeah.
A name describes when you talk about a person who you are, your character, your integrity, your grit. It's just a scope of who the person, that you really are. Mm. If I call any name here, or you do the same thing, you got an illustration or thought in your mind, how do you view that individual? And I want to say this here about a name. Proverbs 22:1 says, a good name is to be chosen, they're enriching in loving favor rather than silver and gold.
Right.
So let me break that down. Don't let nobody, well, let me say this here. Don't let nobody mess your good name up once it's been established.
Yeah.
Right. Because see, we got some character name assassinators that will try to store your very name.
Right.
The very person that you are, the core who you are.
Right.
And when you got a good name, it'll take you places where money can't buy. I'm going to take you back to the country almost 35 years ago.
Okay.
East Oak, North Carolina, where I'm from.
All right.
Mama used to, I shared this story many times. She used to pack, patronize at this country store. And I used to have a ride by some across the thing. I took my nephew out there all the week. And we was all good with that. Don't despise home beginnings.
Yes, sir.
And but mom did a certain kind of work when she got paid once a week. But she had good credit at the store.
Right.
So I rode to the store. I was going to the store with my brother. We were going to the store with mom from time to time. And she knew Miss Harris knew us. And I used to see mom and I was a little boy there. They were right on the book. But mom was establishing a relationship with Miss Harris.
Right.
So when I would go over there, the mom would go, she said, she'll write to James Lee, that's my middle name.
Right.
She said, go over there and get the butter and this type. And when I get over there, Mr. Harris be sitting there, and I go, all right, I ain't gonna go there, but they waiting on me, you know. Harris son. What's she seeing for today? And I'll tip the list. I said, Miss Harris, mama told me she'll pay you on Friday. She said, she will always win.
All right.
She always win.
Uh-huh.
And showing up every Friday. Whether mom made $20, $30 that week doing what she did, she will go in there and pay Miss Harris.
All right.
Because she wanted to make good on her name.
All right, all right, all right.
Come on, man.
I had some issues, and I ain't picking on him. He's my brother, I love him to death. To help somebody else, and I knew a man that had a good name. Brother
Richard.
Now, I went to him for another individual because my name was good.
Come on, man.
You're getting blessed because of your name.
Right.
And your name can carry weight.
Yes, sir.
We living in a society now with number 45.
Come on, man.
They saying calling people any kind of name.
Yes,
I heard last week that there's a man that had his name taken off a football stadium. I didn't know why. I found out he used the word, the name, N-word. And they tell me, a dictionary tell me an N-word is an ignorant person. And I don't see no, and all of us can be called that derogatory name.
Right.
But I don't see no ignorant folks this morning. I see Holy Ghost filled. I see Christian folks. I don't see no ignorant. I don't see no ignorant. I don't see some of names. Because you who you say God said you are. I'm talking about something about that name. There's something in the name.
Yeah.
Keep your good name. Don't let anybody destroy your name.
All right.
Yeah.
Right.
So if we look, Apostle Paul here picks this up in Philippians. Before I build and exegete this text, Paul said that exegete, I don't tell you to break the text down. I ain't nothing big term about that. Let's break the text down. He wanted to talk to the Philippians.
All right.
And let me build it up while I'm getting to exegete. The Philippians was a church that Paul was near and dear to. Out of all the churches that he planted, it was something about the Philippians. They helped Paul at a critical time when Paul was going through. They provided, if you study the church, they provided for him. And Paul never forgot that.
Right.
But Paul had one back, if that's a good word, one issue with the Philippian church.
And he picked it up out of all the good things to do. And Philippians is called the joy epistle. All right. Now, you got to understand this illustration. Now, Paul is writing to the Philippians and us today. He's locked up to a Roman guard. And he got to say, the study said, everywhere the guard go at, Paul has to go with him. Can't go nowhere. He's tired. He's locked up physically, but he's locked up spiritually because now you understand what it's all about.
Right.
And he's telling the Philippians to have some joy.
Right.
That makes sense. Let me move. But the problem that he had with the Philippians, maybe sometime we have today, there was no unity in the body. There was schism. It all like division. So Paul picked up where I get to my piece. He said in verse chapter 2, if there be any consolation in Christ, the comfort of love, in the fellowship of the Spirit, is the affection. Fulfill my joy, being like-minded, having the same love of being on one accord. See, we can be different, but we still got to be on one accord.
Right.
We got to have one same purpose.
Yes.
Everybody's not going to agree on the same thing.
Right.
But when we leave the table,
right,
let me put it that way, we got to at least be on one accord.
Right.
But you know how we are. We be in the room and I don't like that. But still, we need to leave there in one accord.
Yeah.
And then Paul said, let nothing be done through selfish.
Yes.
He's trying to promote humility.
All right.
The illustration. See, a lot of time we want what we want.
Yeah.
We want like Burger King. Want an outlet.
Yeah.
Isn't that right about it?
Yeah.
Amen.
Yes,
and he said, of one mind, let nothing be done through selfish ambition or conceit, but in the lowness of mind, humility. Let each esteem others.
Yes.
I got to encourage you and build you up. I can't tear you down because I'm preaching, I'm teaching. Who do I think I am?
Right.
I got it all together. I'm still working progress too. And I thank God for that. Esteem each other up because you might be up today. But you keep on living. You might be picking somebody to pick you up. Let me get to the book. Let us each other look out to only not just our own interests, but also the interests of others.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know, what that's saying in so many words, I just can't just pray and be concerned about you when I see you. I'm concerned about people when I don't see them.
All right.
I was concerned about the Bonds family this week. I didn't know what it is. It ain't none of my business. But I had a genuine godly concern. And all of you, whether you like me or not,
amen.
I love you.
Amen.
See, you can't make nobody like you or love you.
Right.
You see, this is trust my teeth. You just do the right thing.
Right.
And let them do what they need to do.
Right.
And let God prevail. It's something about that name.
All
right. Then he picked it up while I'm at it, but text said, let this mind be in you.
Yes.
Which was in Christ Jesus. What was that mind you asked the preacher? It was a mind that understood his purpose.
Yeah, all right.
Jesus didn't come here to glorify himself. He came as an obedient servant.
Yes.
To serve the people. See, he could have took on all the deity. And God said, I'm being in the form of God. He said he didn't want to be equal with God.
Yeah.
But he was God in the flesh.
All right.
So he did, and there's a word, this Greek word, it says it's kenosis.
Yeah.
But what kenosis is, he emptied himself.
Yeah.
He came up out of heaven to came down to be the illustration.
Yeah.
The example for us.
All right.
Show us how to live. See, he was tempted as we were, but he was yet without sin.
Because
he prayed high priest. There's something about that name. There's something about that name.
Yeah.
So, no reputation. They say that your reputation will precede itself.
Mm-hmm.
The world say it. You stay humble. Those that humble themselves shall be exalted.
Yeah.
But those that exalt themselves shall be humble.
Yeah.
Humble yourself under the mighty hand of God that you might lift it up and do season.
Okay.
Don't get puffed up. Don't get it. Smell of yourself.
Right.
Think it's all about you.
Yeah.
Let me move.
Bless the Lord.
He came in the form of a bondservant.
Mm.
Come in the likeness of me. He was a man just like me. He hurt, he cried. got tired. He found an appearance of man, and he became obedient to the point of death, even the death of Christ. See, Jesus, through it all, he was fulfilling his mandate, his assignment that his Father had called him to do. We said it in Sunday school this morning, he was obedient. He was obedient even to the death of the cross. And I know sometimes Jesus wanted to give up. But he was obedient and was listening to what the Father, he said, not my will be done, but your will be done, Father. And then by him becoming obedient and humbling himself, check this, there's something about the name. See, by him doing that, I can see the Father say, you know what? Son, since you did that, therefore God has highly exalted him and given him a name that which is above every name. That name bigger than your name. It's bigger than my name. It's something about that name. And what is his name going to do? See, Jesus is no longer walking on the face of this earth. But he left a name. 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 And see, as a lot of people now, I hear praying as I travel. That's praying, not even that name. But let me give you 3 points, 3 nuggets that's unique about this name. First, Puma, a nugget, it's a special name. But preacher, what makes it special? It was a name that was picked by his Father, God. Matthew 1:29 says, Matthew, Mary and Joseph didn't pick that name. They said, and he shall be called Jesus, and he shall save the world from the sin. So it's a special name because the Father of God, the Creator, picked that name. That name is so special because it points back to the Father. It shows you that the name Jesus literally means Jesus is salvation. That showed us in John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever shall believe shall not perish but have everlasting life. That name is special because it tells it what Jesus came to do. Luke 19:10 said, I came to seek and save that which was lost. And second point number two is a stainless name. The name ain't got no blemishes on it. You can't find no fault in this stainless name. It's a name that we have to revere. Point three, it's a saving name. You heard Acts 4:12. Muhammad name can't save you. Buddha name can't save you. My name can't save you. Your name can't save you. What the book say? There's no other name up on the heaven that you can be saved by except by the name of Jesus. The church, New Mission Baptist Church, name can't save him. Let me say right there.
Bless the name of Jesus.
You can come to church all the way up. Preach, Rev, you can say hey, and camp out in the pulpit. Do twit, do cock, let all go home. Can't hear the Jesus come back. Tell people, I go to New Mission Baptist Church. Okay. Jesus going to come back? Okay. That's good. That name can't save you out there. And I'm telling you, I want you to come to New Mission Baptist Church of Christ. We ought to come. Forsake not the sins of God. We got to come. But I'm trying to tell you, Jesus is a saving name. And if you want to be saved, the pastor name can't save you. The preacher name can't save you. The deacon name can't save you. The mother name can't save you. We're doing everything in it to try to keep our name. Tell the Lord, let me tell you. I got to say this.
No matter what your tag and title is, you got the same requirements.
All right.
The Bible says that's a, it's a name. Now, 3 points.
Glory.
But I got to get out of here.
Because
I believe there's something about the name you're going to call.
Yes.
That Bible said every knee is going to bow.
Yes.
And every tongue going to confess.
Yes.
What's in heaven and under earth.
Yes.
Even the demons going to have to bow at the name of Jesus.
Yes.
There's something about that name. Yes. On this July 22nd, 2018.
Yes.
I want to tell you, I told you about what's special about the name, but I want to tell you, there's something about the name.
Yes.
I got you fooled. You think I'm getting to walk to ABC, but I'm not going to ABC this morning. I'm going to take you home. I'm going to tell you something about this name.
Yes.
First, there's authority in the name.
Alright.
He's giving us authority. God giving authority.
Yes.
You can speak. Life and death is in the power of tongue. You got authority. You can't speak in your name.
All right.
Jesus gave you God gives authority. It's up to you to walk in.
Yes. Amen.
Glory. That God. Name will be exalted.
Uh-huh.
It's the most excellent name
yes.
in all the earth.
Yes.
There's access
uh-huh.
in that name.
All right.
Talking about future.
Yes.
John 14:6 says. I'm the way, the truth, the truth.
Yeah.
And the Bible. No man
uh-huh.
come to the Father uh-huh. except uh-huh. by the Son.
All right. Yeah.
If you want to get to God.
Yeah. Jesus.
Brother Mitchell, can I say this here? Me and Brother Mitchell come in this morning. And I said, Brother Mitchell, that door was open. And we were just chugging in the parking lot. I love him, my brother. We was talking to him.
Well, that's the
name. I said, Brother, I seen that door. I said, and Deacon Gunn was coming in. And I'm going to move. And we came in. And I said, he said, well, he didn't think it was like, he said, well, I got the key. What I'm saying? See, but I have that key. He had access to this church.
Right.
He didn't open. He said, when I go around, I open the place. I said, brother, I got my key. He said, okay. He kept on walking. What I'm saying? If you want to get to God, you got to go through the sewer.
Right now. All right.
That's the access.
All right now.
There's glory.
Uh-huh.
Jesus, Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
God will share his glory with you.
Yeah.
You can shout glory when hell is running rampant. Because it's glory. I said it's glory. It's glory. It's glory. And I want to go back to authority. When you got authority. See James 2:19 said, you believe that which is good.
Jesus.
But even the devils believe they tremble.
Yeah.
But you can call them out. You can call a spade a spade in the heart of heart.
Yes.
There's glory in that name.
Yes.
My God.
There's life in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
John 10:10 said, the devil come to seek, kill, and destroy.
Yes.
But I came to give life and give life more than life.
Yes.
And there's joy.
Yes,
sir. Unspeakable joy.
Unspeakable.
We've been made to endure through the night.
Yes.
But joy. Fall in the devil's temptation,
yes.
knowing that it's going to work your patience.
Yes.
I say there's joy. The joy of the Lord is my strength.
Yes.
I tell you, when it seems all hell breaking loose,
yes.
don't know where to turn. When it's stacked up in you,
yes.
you will stand up and say, all right, it's going to be all right.
Yes.
It ain't just a smile,
right.
it's joy.
No.
I say it's joy.
No.
I see it's a fool of the spirit.
Uh-huh.
So you can't get that at fool line.
All right. Yeah,
it's joy. When you go through,
Jesus
went through and Paul went through.
Yes.
Don't get better. Get better. Don't worry about what they done to you. Because God will turn it around.
Yes.
If you can continue in that name.
Yes.
And last but not least, there's power.
Power.
Hunger, working power. In the name of Jesus, which is called Christ.
Yes.
And he's giving you the power.
Mm.
All you have to do, church, my brothers and sisters in Christ, walk in your divine power. Because the Bible says, after that which after the Holy Ghost have come upon you, you shall receive power. There's something about that name.
Yes.
He left that name here for a reason. And church, we're living in the world now. Yes. We're selling all kind of names, doing all kind of things.
Yeah.
Even in the house of God.
Right.
Not people. And then, you know, Holy Ghost, the man of God, Reverend Roy, last week, I came back, I had to go to work. He was pointing out, sitting right there. And who was here, he just said, God, call that name. Jesus. Now, I didn't know what I was going to preach today. But I'm telling you, church, if we don't get back on our knees, on our hands, and get our place, and start back praying in the Jesus' name, we ain't going to ruin this country, our churches, our homes, our families, our school system. School giving to start back now. I've been praying over three of class. I was praying all night up there. They didn't see me praying. But let me tell you something. I just heard it. Young people, you can take prayer out of school. You can't take prayer out of you.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
Teach them how to pray in that name. Teach them how to pray. So when you leave them, you drop them off.
All right.
They know the name.
All right.
He ain't here, but he can call that name.
Yeah.
You know, I'm doing this. What's amazing about that name? Even atheists and people don't believe in God, they'll get in trouble.
talking.
Yeah, call that name Jesus.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. Oh, what about him? Can I hear a witness? Yes,
sir.
Guess what? I used to be one. All right? Holy than thou.
Uh-huh.
Ain't always been saved.
That's right.
You know what? I'm closing. Don't think that he's not hearing you. Because the fervent, effective prayer of the righteous man availeth
much.
He heard you. He might just haven't responded to the issue yet.
Yes.
The Lord.
He might have not manifested that healing yet.
Yeah.
That financial breakthrough you're looking for. Whatever it is, that situation with your child, or that situation with anything. But God heard it when you called that name.
Yeah.
There's authority in that name. And church, don't get to a place where you have no other choice. Don't be like the two thieves on the cross. They thought they had all kind of time. This could be your last moment.
Yes.
Thank you, Brother Richmond. Last week, I'm closing. I was sitting in the pulpit and Brother Richmond was right there. I mean, Brother Deacon Moore was right there. And just before the service started, we went up each other, embraced each other. Right here, we talked. I said, let me shake your hand, Reverend. I said, God bless you. I said, Deacon, how your mother doing? She said, I heard she was dying. I hadn't seen him in a while. She said, yes, she's doing good, Reverend. Oh, I was glad she came down. Now that was something. Now one day this week I was coming in and I got a text from Deacon McNeil. Mama gone. It could have been the other way.
Yeah.
I said all that to say this right here. Don't leave here today. And have not accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Savior.
Yes, sir.
This could be your last opportunity.
Yes.
And for us to have a seven, keep on walking with him. Keep on building your relationship with him. Thank you, Deacon Hurst, this morning. Keep on building that relationship with him.
Amen.
And I'm going to tell you.
Amen.
He's better than the 1-800 number. One of the first used to work for telecom company. Sometimes one of the first one that worked, she didn't work 24/7. But you can call that name Jesus. Early in the morning, midday hour, late at night. He never sleeps no something. There's something about the name of Jesus. Amen. Would there be one this morning?
In the Lord.
Would there be one this morning that want to come and give their life to the Lord? You can come as a candidate for baptism. You can come. If you're already saved, you don't have a church home, you can come by Christian Experience. The Lord just wants you to come. Come as you are. He's here with open arms. If you come.
In the Lord.
Everybody, right?
Lord, as bold as we know how. Lord, you said we can come to your throne boldly.
Yes.
Some have come this morning to the altar, oh God.
Yes, Jesus.
You know them by name. You know them when they came here for. So, Lord, we put it at your feet this morning, oh God. Father God, you know even the number of hairs on all of our heads. Father God, you know what's needed, oh God. We just pray that your will be done in every situation. Father God, you continue to strengthen us. Build us up in the most holy faith. Oh, Father God, we ask you, Father God, that you just intercede. That you be the chief intercessor, oh God. That we know not what we ought to pray for, but the Holy Spirit make it intercession to us, oh God. Through moments and moments, oh God. We thank you for the service, oh God. We thank you for the choir. We thank you for every soul that came out, oh God. We thank you for the ushers, oh God. We thank you for our musician. We thank you for even one that family served. But Lord, we're here to give you all the glory to you. Because it belongs to you, oh God. Continue to saturate this place, oh God. And let us continue to know, Father God, that you're able to be exceedingly abundant and more we can even ask. Thank you for the power that worketh in us. We give you glory, we give you honor. So Lord, we prepare to leave this place. Whenever you're praying, go with us today, oh God. And we may continue to walk to let our light so shine. That people may see our good work. But we glorify the Father in heaven. And give us the ability, oh God, even to treat everybody right, to love our enemies, pray for those that despise you. Have your way, that your will be done. And after you have done these things, we will have to know without a shadow of a doubt that it had to be the Lord's doing. And it will be marvelous in our sight. It's in Jesus' name we do pray. Amen. Amen. I'll be remiss. I thank you, everybody that came this morning, all the support. Now just continue, as you continue to pray for me and my family, that we will be what God will have us be.
Yes.
We're so grateful and thankful, no matter what goes after. I'm glad to say this, no matter what transpires. I'll still love everyone in this place with the love of Christ. I wish you Godspeed. And I pray your hearts be encouraged. There's something about that. If all minds and hearts are kept, let us lift our hands in benediction. Now may the grace of God and the sweet communion of His Holy Spirit rest on the body henceforth now and forevermore. As we sing with the choir.
Yeah.